Hello and welcome to a new video from Advanced Power Query series. This video APQ02, we are going to discuss parameters, and parameters is nothing but a variable that you can declare inside the Power Query editor and use it inside a function or inside another calculation, or even you can use it to change the source of your data file, as we are going to see during this video. So in this video we are going to see four things. First one, how to use the parameter as a variable inside a calculation. And then we're going to see how we can use parameter to dynamically change the source of our data. And also we can see that we can create our own parameters inside our worksheet instead of creating the parameter inside the Power Query editor itself. And finally, we are going to look at two good functions, two good M functions. First one is file.contents and the second one is excel.workbook. In the practical example for today, I have a folder containing three files. Let's open Gen 19 as an example to look at the data inside each and every file. Here is the first file, Gen 19. You'll see that it has five columns. First one is the month, and then the name of the sales rep, and then the quantity sold for the month for each sales rep, and then the amount of sales, and finally the commission point earned by each and every sales rep. The requirement is to calculate the commission value, and this will be simply the commission points times a factor. This factor represents the value for each point. And let's say that we have three options. It can be $0.5 for each point, or $1 for each point, or 1.5. This will depend on the company's policy for each month for a certain period or for a certain. So in order to start work on this using Power Query, I'm going to close this file. And to start from a blank workbook, I'm going to select data ribbon. On the left hand side, I have the Power Query section. I'm going to get data, and then from file, and then from workbook, and then I'm going to select Gen 19, the first file, and then click on import, and this will trigger the navigator. From the navigator window, on the left hand side, I have the name of my workbook, gen19.xlsx, and then the name of the sheet, which is sheet 1. Let me select sheet 1. I have the preview of data here. I can just click on transform data, and this will trigger the Power Query editor. On the right hand side, I have the name of the query from the name of the sheet. Let me change it to commission report, and then enter. And I have the three steps. First one, Excel.workbook, and then file contents in order to open the file, the Excel workbook file, and then navigate. This is when I selected the sheet one, and then promote headers, and then finally change type, and all the steps is fine for me. Nothing to change here. The only step I want to add is just to calculate the commission. In order to do this, I need to multiply this by one of the three options or the three factors that I'm going to use. So let me select the commission points column, and then going to add column, and then from number section, standard, I'm going to select the multiply. From the multiply window, it will ask me what exactly the value I need to multiply for each and every row. Let me start with the 0.5, the first option, and then I'm going to click on OK. It will add, as you can see, a new column called multiplication, and each and every value multiplied by 0.5. So you can see here 16,000 multiplied by 0.5, it will give you the 8.1 for the first sales rep. In order to have this in a form of report, I need to change the header from multiplication to be something like commission value. I can just double click on the header and then change, and this will add a new step here. But let me, instead of doing this, I'm going to the formula bar, and I can see here inside the table.addColumn function, I'll see that here is the name of the new column. I can just select by the mouse and then overwrite. I can just write something like commission value, and then enter, and here I change directly within the same step the header of the new column. But now I told you that I have three options, 0.5 and 1 and then 1.5. I want to select this value instead of just adding or hard coding the 0.5 inside this formula. I need to have a place that I can use, or a variable that I can use, in order to select the correct value. And in order to do this, I can use the parameter. From home ribbon, I can go to manage parameter and then new parameter. This will open a window to create a new parameter. I can give a name to the parameter. Let me call it value per point. Then I can give a description. Let me do something like the value per each commission point, something like this. I can add more. It's up to you. The type of data, the default is any, but I'm going to select from the drop down. I'm going to select the decimal number, because this will be 0.5 or 1 or 1.5, so it is a decimal number. And then I can choose a current value, which will be 0.5, and then click on OK. Once I do this, On the left-hand side, you will see a new item in your queries, and this item is basically a parameter, and here is the value of the parameter. You can just edit and change. In order to link my query, the original query, the commission query, to this parameter, I'm going back to commission report, and then from the final step, insert multiplication, I can go to the formula bar, and I can select the 0.5, the hard-coded 0.5, and instead of using the 0.5 hard-coded, I can use the name of the parameter, which is basically value per point. If you click on the check mark, I think you will get the same result, no problem, so it is now accepted. If you go back to the value per point, and then you change this to, let's say, 1, and then go back to commission report, let's check the final column. You can see that now it is multiplied by 1, because 16,000 times 1 is 16,000, and so on and so forth. So it is now dynamic. You can just go to the parameter and change the value input for the parameter, and then it will directly impact the commission report. But now, what if I know it will be only one of the three values? I need something like a drop down menu, like what we do inside a normal Excel sheet. I can go back to manage parameter, and from manage parameter, I can go to suggested value, and from the drop down, I can select list of values, and this will give me this small window. In the first line, I can enter 0.5. This is my first selection. And then on the plus, I can click on the plus. And then again, inside the line 2, I can put 1.0. And finally, in the third line, I can enter 1.5. So this is the three options that I have. If you go to default value, you will see that you can select from the drop-down. I'm going to select the 0.5 again. And the current value also you can select from the drop-down. I have the three options. So I'm going also to select 0.5 and then click on OK. Now the parameter input is 0.5, and here you can see the drop down. You can just select from the drop down. Let me this time select the 1.5 and go back to the commission report. If you check the final column, you see that it is now multiplied times 1.5. Now my query is ready. I can just go to close and load 2. From import data window, let me select table and then existing worksheet. Let me select A3 and then click on OK. My table will be loaded, including the new column that I added. And also I have here in the queries and connection, I have list of two items, my query, and also the value per point parameter. And between two brackets, you can notice the value selected. So you can just double click on it and go back and change the value. And this will be reflected automatically after you refresh your query. Another practical example, which is basically changing the source of query using a parameter. Remember that inside my folder, I have three sheets. First one for Jan, and then Feb, and then March. And suppose that I want to use a parameter to select whatever file I want to select inside this query. In order to do this, I'm going back to my commission report. And let me select the very first step, which is the source. And if you open the formula bar right here, you'll see that you have the excel.workbook function and then file.content function, and you have the address of your workbook. Let me select the entire address and then control C to copy, and let me go to home ribbon again, manage parameter and new parameter. Let me this time give a name for the parameter as a file path. Then description section is optional. I'm going to leave it for the moment. The type of the data will be text for this time. Suggested value, let me put again a list of values. The first value, I'm going to just double click and control V. Here you go, the path for Jan 19 Excel workbook. And then add a new value, double click and control V. Again, I have Jan 19, but I can change this to Feb 19. Again, I'm going to add another value, double click, control V. Let me change it to March 19 this time. Down to default value, I'm going to select the first selection, which is basically Jan 19, and the same for the current value, it will be Jan 19, and then click on OK. A new parameter created, and you can see you have a drop-down menu of three options. You can see the path is too long, but no problem if you just select inside the cell and go to the right, you will see exactly the last part of your selection. So let me select February for the moment, and let me go back to the commission report, and let me see how can I put this inside my query. I'm going back to the source step, and inside the file.content function, I'm going to select the entire path of the file, and then backspace to delete, and then I'm going to write the file path parameter inside this function, and then click on the tick mark, and here you go, you get the same result. If you select the final step, you will see that now the query is pointing to February. Let me collapse this one. Let me go back to the file path parameter. I'm going to select March, for instance, and then go back to test. to commission report. Here you go, you have Marsh data. If you can just close and then keep in order to save the change that you did. And now the Marsh data is loaded and all the changes done accordingly. What if I want to add my parameter value from the Excel sheet itself? There is another solution we can do together. Let me now give a name for this sheet, and let me call it commission report P. P stands for parameter for sure. And I'm going to select a new sheet, and let me call it the same name, commission report SP or sheet parameter. Let me start by file address here. This will be the label that I'm going to use. And I'm going to paste here the path of one of the files. Let's say the February path. Then I'm going to do some formatting. I have the path inside the Excel sheet. I want to take this inside the Power Query editor. In order to do this, I need to convert this into a table, or I can just give a name to this specific cell to consider it as a named range. In order to do this, I'm going to select A1 and B1 together, and then going to formula, and from define names, I'm going to select create from selection. It will sense automatically that you have a name coming from the left column. Then I'm going to click on OK. And if you check now the cell B1, you'll see it's named file address. This appears in the name bar. And this is qualified now to be pushed inside the Power Query. I'm going to data ribbon again, and then I'm going to select from sheet icon. It will trigger automatically the Power Query editor, and you'll have here three steps: source, then promote header, I don't know why, and also change type. And all of this for me is not needed. I need only the source. So I'm going to select promote headers and then right click and then delete until end. It will delete the two steps after the source step. Now I have one column, and this column containing only one record. If you select this record and then right click and drill down, you will see that you will get a single value, and this value is text value. You can check this from the left hand side. You have a new item called file address, and you will see that it is ABC, meaning that it is text. For sure, a new step created called navigation. If you check from formula bar, it is nothing but selecting from the source step, which is the previous step, selecting the first column and the first record. And you can check here from the zero, this zero meaning that I am selecting the first record, because you know that Power Query is zero based. The first record in each column is basically represented by zero. So inside the second step, you see zero selected between two curly brackets, and this is the operator to locate a record. And then between two square brackets, and this is the operator also to locate the columns, it is selected the first column. So the intersection between first column and the first record will give you this text, which is basically the file path for Feb 19 file. But this is not exactly what I need. I need the file inside this path, not the path as a text. I need the file inside this path. So I can go again inside the formula bar, and before the source table, I can just write something like file, a function like file.content. And here you go, I can see it in the screen assistance. I can just hit tab and it will be selected. Let me open one bracket and close the bracket at the end, and then the check mark, and you can see that I get the Excel file from this path, no problem. But this is not exactly what I want. I want also to use the excel.workbook function in order to get the information inside this workbook. So I can just go again in the same step on the formula bar, and before the file.contents function, I can use excel.workbook, which is basically the first choice. I can just hit the tab key and then open the bracket and close the bracket at the end, and then hit enter, and you will see that you can manage to get the content from the Excel file that you selected from the previous step. So if you check the data column, you will see that you have the data here. This is the preview of your data, and you'll notice that you have column 1, column 2, up to column 5, and then the first record contain the actual headers, which is month, sales rep, total quantity, and so on and so forth. I need to promote this first record to be the headers of the table. In order to do this, I can just use a function like table.promoteHeaders. However, there is a very good option inside the Excel.workbook itself. If you add a new parameter after the file pass, it is optional. I can do a comma and then type true in a small letter, and you will see it will be turned to blue, like you can see here. And if you go to the end and then hit enter, and then you check again inside the data column, but you need to select on the white space here, on the white area here, you will see that now the headers is promoted, and now I'm ready to expand this column. Let me first get rid of the rest of the columns. I'm going to select the data column, right click, remove other column, and then expand. I'm going to uncheck your original column name as prefix, and then click on OK, and you'll have all your data expanded here. Now let me change data types. I can do it automatically, going to transform, detect data types. It will do it for you. All data types is fine. Finally, I need to add the very last column in order to calculate the commission value. So I'm going to take the commission points, add column, from number, standard, multiply. Let me start with any value. Let's put it like 1 and then okay. I'm going to the last step and then edit, multiplication. I'm going to change this to commission value. And then the multiplication times 1, let me select the name of the variable, will be, or name of the parameter, will be value per point. And then the check mark, and now it is working perfectly. I have my selection impacting this. You can see that I have 1.5. The first record for February showing 13.5 more or less, times 1.5, it will give you approximately 20,000. So it is working perfectly. Let me load this query. Home, close and load, close and load to. Existing worksheet. Let me select A3 and click on OK. My table now is loaded. As you can see, I have the Feb information. If you want to change this, let me go to edit the file path. I'm going to select B2, and instead of Feb, let me delete and select something like March and enter. Select your table, right click and refresh. And here you go, you have March information and all the calculation. So you managed to view the parameter from two different angles. The first one is if you want to get the parameter inside Power Query itself, you have two practical uses. One of them is to use it as a variable inside a function. Second one is to use it as a changer for the file path, or dynamic change for the file path. But you have to create parameters inside the Power Query itself, and you have to change the value from inside Power Query. Or the alternative solution, you create your own parameter input inside the Excel sheet, and then you can use it inside the Power Query. That was all for today. If you like the video, please like it, subscribe to the channel, and leave me a comment. And you'll find here some links to some other series. Please go and check it out. And thank you very much for your time. Hope you enjoy it. And see you in the next video. And bye.